Hello, and welcome to a Smurd P video, if I can get my camera correctly. What on earth is it doing there? And today we are looking at Transformers War for Cybertron Trilogy Generations. Transmutate. Yes, Transmutate. Now we have the usual box that is expected with Generations. We have the beautiful, weird stuff in there. And then we have Transmutate there. I'm going to go get him out of his cardboard cage because that is good. I like that. Environmentally friendly rather than plastics. Where to begin? Where to begin indeed? Now, Hasbro, yeah, they've done this a few times with Transmutate. Transmutate is a Transformer in the original Beast Wars. Couldn't transform, couldn't change. They made one using the RC body from Transformers Prime once upon a time and made a version of Transmutate, and they have done it here. I would have personally preferred it if they had just given us what we wanted as fans, an actual Transmutate deluxe figure that we can use, where hopefully they keep making these beautiful Hasbro Beast Wars figures and they don't stop, and we get perhaps some trans metals. I don't know, we may get lucky. They may just cut that at some point, who knows. With Hasbro, lots of things out there. I mean, they, you know, you could, there's still plenty of G1 figures out there, let alone Beast Wars characters. So they've decided to use the Velociraptor figure from series 1 of the Kingdom line. And they have given us this. And sorry, in the background, it's a madhouse downstairs. Whatever the hell they're doing, I don't know. But it's a madhouse. All I can hear is screaming and singing and all sorts of family stuff that happens. So, and here we go. We've got one coming in the room and interrupting. There we go. Hello, sweetheart. You want to say Sank? What do we? What do you think of the figure?
Good.
You think he's good?
Yeah.
I think it's a she. Well, I'm not sure. It could be a boy or a girl. What would you like to call her? Or him? Or her?
Girlie.
Girlie. Okay. We have named Transmutate Girlie. Right, kiddo. I'll see you later. Love you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. You want to say goodbye to everyone?
Bye.
There we go. Hey, so back to the figure. So they have, oh gosh, slammed the door. So they've used Velociraptor body to give us this monstrosity. And I'm going to be honest with you, I have no intention of keeping this figure because it's not what I wanted. Because I am hurt that Hasbro's lack of feelings towards the fans have given us this. Although, I've got to say, it does look crazily disgusting. So from that perspective, I do actually think it's quite cool. And like the other figure, which I never bought, bits, no, maybe bits don't come off. Bits come off there. Okay, cool. So, yeah, oh, it's got an opening mouth. That's pretty cool. I like that. On the back, you got this giant, wow, giant head sculpt on there, which looks pretty cool. And then like that. So, from a, I guess, If it wasn't a figure that I actually liked, this could actually be quite a cool figure, but it is a figure I like. It also comes with this thing, which you put on here, and it kind of goes, oh, I don't know what on earth it's trying to do. So here is Transmutate's Aut Mode, and it's exactly the same as the one that was made earlier this year. It's a Velociraptor skeleton. Now, the skeletons in their Aut Modes, I find are absolutely brilliant. I actually think they look very, very nice. And they're a very, very cool mode. And they look really good in terms of the detail. I guess with this one, and, you know, the mouse open, do all that. And, you know, they got all this stuff going on so you can get into different poses. And it's got a little arms as well, which is cool. So ultimately, this mode is very cool. I love this mode. The only thing that I feel perhaps doesn't work in particular with this figure is the color scheme. You know, we got the turquoise blue because that's transmutates color mixed with some sort of fossilized golden look. Now, in terms of the original release, the colors were spot on, absolutely perfect, and it looks absolutely gorgeous. Not that I have one in hand, but I've seen reviews because I like watching other people's reviews of these figures, and it looks very nice. So I that would be a downfall for this. So once again, you're still only getting this figure for nostalgia reasons, but even from nostalgia reasons, I'm not impressed, because even though it's cool that they've given us transmutate figure, I would have rather them gone out and given us what we actually wanted to see. So, and that's been my whole opinion from the start, is it's a great idea from Hasbro, great milking opportunity. Unfortunately, you're still not giving the fans what they actually really want. So, the other thing is, there are two other modes which I'm going to show you, which are combined with other Transformers. Now, these I am very fond of and very impressed with. These I always enjoy doing. So I'm going to go do that now off screen, because we know that I'm rubbish on screen. So this is the sort of thing that I enjoy about these figures that they come apart. And this is where Hasbro, I feel, are geniuses in giving us something extra. Because if you look at the figure, it's a figure that many of us probably have overlooked, apart from completists or people that review everything, have grabbed. For me, this is nothing more than a very cool gimmick that would perhaps entice me to buy it, because I feel that actually this adds value to the figure. So first of all, we have the amazing carved axe, which I think is absolutely bang on. Then we got a little shield here, sits on the top, which is the chest piece, and then we've got this, which I feel is, it's kind of like a shield, but it can also be, I don't know, a grabber of some sort. I don't know, or it just protects the hand as well, or acts as another hand. This thing I find is absolutely shocking. It's just the head. Oh, and by the way, this is not the figure that they recommend you put it with. They recommend you put it with a Warpath. However, these figures you can almost put with anything, because they've got similar portholes in the same area. So unless they haven't, then it doesn't work. Now, the grabbers, these bits I find very cool, because you can adjust. They can go up, they can go down. They could be like, you know, keeping two bots there while he's smashing one in the front. I don't know, crazy stuff. Do you know what I mean? The thought patterns are limitless with this. So I'm big fan of this mode. And on Jackie, it looks pretty cool. Very impressed. So let's go look at the second mode. Okay, so this mode probably isn't a favorite of mine compared to the other one. I think I prefer the other one to this. So what they've done is you can make him taller with these little claw feet down there, which is cool, but now you got to be a bit more careful of how you stand him. A big part of this is you put the head under here, and it connects to the other head, and then you add the massive axe on the back, and it creates like a thing. And the way that I look at this, you get like a shield there, and then you got something to, I don't know, stab. That's the only thing I think of that. Don't go stabbing people, please. I do not condone that kind of behavior if you are listening to me as a responsible adult. And then we have these two bits. These two bits are probably my favorite because they look like little cannons now. And you can just give a little blast if he wants. So this mode, not my favorite compared to the last one, but it does add a certain bit of fun to it. And if I'm thinking about it being a children's toy as well, I think it's a great toy to give to your kid, because they can just do whatever they want, break it apart, put it together, create new modes, etc. So, very, very cool. And I think Hasbro did something similar with Power Rangers a while back, that from different years, you could connect the Zords to different Zords. and, you know, try and make different combinations if you want. So that sort of stuff's cool. I think it's cool. A lot of fun. So there we go. There is that mode. So just to wrap it up, this figure may not be the figure that I want personally, but it does have a lot of cool features that can be played with, messed around with, and do whatever you want with. So all in all, it's a cool figure. It's a great idea, but not really given what the fans that they want. But I've also got to give Hasbro some kudos as well. That, even though it's an exclusive, that Ravage that is coming up, that's the sort of thing we want. We want that figure. We want that perfection. Just give us what we want. It's that simple. We will buy up. Look how many Ultra Magnuses they've sold. Who would have thought it? Ultra Magnus. You know, they keep re-releasing that, but then they won't re-release a Bumblebee, which is ridiculous because that will sell again. And Bumblebee will sell. I'm telling you, it will sell well over. People paying 60, sometimes 70 odd quid for that figure, which is a 20 to 25 quid figure, you know. It's absolutely bonkers. Hasbro, you know, you're missing a big opportunity here to make money, not because we're mugs, but because the fandom is that big that it wants these characters. And Transmutate is another one. Okay, perhaps you send it out as an exclusive, you know, and you reduce it. I don't know. Just to get a feel for it. Is it going to sell? Is it not? I don't know. I don't know how much it costs to build a new mode either. But, you know, you've delivered Ravage on a Cheetah body, which looks phenomenal, you know, and it's everybody's excited for that. Give us this as well. There are some hardcore Beast War fans out there that would love to see that Transmutate particular body. And the only real thing that we've got in the past is we've got the 10th anniversary version. And we've recently had the Trans Art Strange Friend, which sold out. You know, I had to buy on the second market because I was late to the game with Trans Art. But it's certainly worth it. So thank you for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. Really appreciate that. And embrace the geekiness. Take care. Goodbye. Please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Instagram, Cyclops Smurd. I'm on Twitter at SmurdP. No idea what I'm doing there. I'm also got a page on Facebook, SmurdP. And embrace the geekiness. Thank you for watching. Take care. Goodbye.